You are listening to PT on Ice, The Older Adult, a collaboration between the Senior Rehab Project and the Institute of Clinical Excellence. This is a rebroadcast of an original episode that can be found at ptonice.com.
Hello, everybody. Christina Previtt here. I am one of the two faculty leading the Modern Management of the Older Adult course. I am so sorry for the delay in this live video. I did do this video at 8:30, but I did it on Stave Off's page. It's just been one of those mornings. We have a new cohort of the Modern Management of the Older Adult course starting this Sunday. I am super, super excited. Dustin and I, every time we go through the course, we get feedback from some of our students about what you want to see more of and less of and how we can improve. And so we're making some moves and rejigs to the course. We're really, really excited about it. So today for PT on Ice, I wanted to talk a little bit about diastasis recti. If we have any pelvic floor physiotherapists or orthopedic physical therapists that work with moms postnatally, diastasis recti is something that's in your everyday conversation. But sometimes it's not necessarily what we think of for older adults. And I want to kind of go through some of the things that I've been seeing in the clinic in terms of diastasis recti. So number one, what is diastasis recti? This is something that's become increasingly more popular, or I shouldn't say popular, but more spoken about in the last 5 or 10 years, with more awareness of moms' health issues becoming more in the realm of physical therapy. And so diastasis recti is a separation of the abdominal wall. We have our two big rectus muscles that are joined by the linea alba. And as a mom progresses through her pregnancy and we have the baby taking up more space and having this distension anteriorly of the abdominal muscles, eventually that tensile strength can become too much and we can have a separation of the abdominal muscles. This is very common during pregnancy and is actually relatively normal, with most women having a natural closure of the diastasis happening within the first 6 months after pregnancy. What I've been seeing lately is that a lot of my clients who are in their 50s or 60s are also coming with the diastasis recti. And it's, to be honest, it is not something that I would even have had on my radar to be assessing regularly, especially with some of my male clients, because it's not necessarily something that I generally think of. What's been bringing this to my attention is actually some of the exercise programs that I've been doing with some of my older clients. We have a master's group and we do a little bit of floor core work in our accessory components. And as people were doing things that required them to bring their abdomen into the middle, things like leg lifts or a dead bug or some sort of variation, I was seeing this stereotypical coning that we see with diastasis recti, where we have this bulging of skin that happens right in the center of the abdomen, happening with some of my older clients, and not just my older women. And it started to make me wonder if I was missing something on my orthopedic assessment. And so as I was seeing some clients with low back pain, I made a diastasis recti check, one of the things that was part of my standard assessment, and I noticed that oftentimes there was a noticeable diastasis with my older clients. A reminder of how we assess for a diastasis recti: you're gonna have your client lying supine. You're going to be palpating an inch above at the level of the belly button, at the level of the belly button, and an inch below the belly button. And you're gonna get them to do a crunch with your hand palpating for the coming together of the two rectus muscles. And you're looking for a gap. Anything over 2 finger breaths at any level is going to be indicative of at least a mild to moderate diastasis, with anything over 3 to 4 finger breaths being a relatively severe diastasis. What I've been seeing with my older clients is sometimes as they transition through menopause, they've either had a diastasis recti for as long as they can remember, and they've never really thought anything of it because They were told when their kids were little that this was just mom belly or a natural part of having kids, or, you know, you've had three kids and it's not something that was actually addressed by the medical profession. And so now that we're seeing some declines in strength as people get into their older decades, this lack of transfer of force in the anterior core may be contributing slightly to the experience of low back pain, and something that we might have to address. The other thing is with my older men who have experienced periods of relatively rapid weight gain, it mimics a lot of the things that women experience during pregnancy. If you're having a period of time where you've put on, 10, 15, 20, 25 pounds in, under a year, sometimes this happens within a 6 month span. An example is when I have a lot of my clients who quit smoking, sometimes they put on 20, 25 pounds or changes in medication that cause weight gain. What doctors are often assessing for is hernia. And so I had an older gentleman who's in his 60s who had a very noticeable diastasis recti, and he had had 5 hernia repairs. And so the medical profession, he hadn't seen a physiotherapist, had addressed the hernia, but hadn't necessarily talked to him about the diastasis. And so because of that, we had to do a lot of education around, changing the way that he was recruiting his abdominal muscles, thinking about drawing in each side of his abdomen rather than pushing out in order to engage those muscles. And we saw a noticeable decline in the diastasis with just a couple of simple cues. So one of the things that's really wonderful about working with some of my older clients is that usually it doesn't take very much in terms of intervention for me to be able to work with my client to at least improve the look or the tensile strength across the midline. And my clients in the exercise program have actually done a really wonderful job of being able to recruit those abdominal muscles in a proper way and not progress their core exercises when they're starting to experience that coning or that tenting that they're seeing as an evidence of diastasis. And so what I've seen with some of my chronic low back pain with some of my older clients is that the diastasis, fixing that drawing in posturing or that stability across the midline, has actually allowed them to be more supported through their trunk and has actually looked to improve some of their symptoms of diastasis recti. Just something that I was kind of thinking about and thought that it might be useful to you. Do you guys do a diastasis check with some of your older clients? Especially because, when some of my clients in their 60s were having children, diastasis and different things around incontinence and pelvic floor health were just not talked about as readily, and the information wasn't as available as it is today. And so that was a big learning curve for me, and something that as I was seeing more of my older clients working through the gym and seeing just how common it was, I once had a class of 6 people and 4 of them were showing evidence of diastasis, men and women. And so it was relatively shocking how high the percentage of individuals over 60 who are exhibiting signs of diastasis. And we know that as part of the aging process, we don't have the same level of tensile strength in some of our tendons. And therefore, that actually might be a risk factor for further diastasis or slow recovery of that diastasis if one develops. So I hope you guys found that helpful. If you have any other questions or comments, please put them below. Otherwise, have a wonderful week. We will see you in a couple of weeks. Dustin's got the PT on Ice Jerry PT version next week. And if you have any questions about the modern management of the older adult course online or some of our live options that are now on the website, feel free to comment below. Bye, guys.
Hit me. Thank you for listening. And if you enjoyed this episode, go to ptonice.com, click on the courses tab, and check out Modern Management of the Older Adult. This is a course that myself and Christina Previtt are going to be teaching. It's 8 weeks, an online format, interactive, and solely focused on helping students change how they practice and how they work with older adults. For more information, just go to ptonice.com. Thanks.